गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द चैप्टर विथ न्यू सब टॉपिक्स, बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर वी विल रिवाइज द सब टॉपिक विच वी स्टडीड इन द लास्ट क्लास. द सब टॉपिक इज बियॉन्ड बिग सिटीज ट्राइबल सोसाइटीज. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट ट्राइबल सोसाइटीज. इन लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ द सब कॉन्टिनेंट society was already divided according to the rules of Varna, and these rules as prescribed by the Brahmanas. Understand? Division of society on the basis of Varna system, according to it, society was divided into four groups. These were in four parts. These were first one Brahmins, second one Kshatriyas, third Vaisya, fourth Sudras. Understand? Society was divided into four parts on that time. Understand? But tribal societies in the subcontinent, other kinds of societies as well existed as well. And these societies did not follow the social rules and rituals prescribed by the Brahmanas. Understand? And nor were they divided into numerous unequal classes. Such societies are often called tribes. Understand? Means tribes were not believing, not following the rituals and dogmas that were made by Brahmanas. Understand? And their societies were not divided unequally. They were living in equality. So enjoy the class. And dear students, we will continue the subtopic who were tribal people, because the subtopic was incomplete in the last class. We will know about more tribal people here. The Balochis were important and powerful tribe in the northwest, and they were divided into many smaller clans under different chiefs. Clans means a group of families or household claiming descent from a common ancestors. Tribal organization is often based on kinship or clan loyalties. It means that clan means that the families of tribe, especially the Balochis, they believe that they belong to the same ancestor. Their ancestors are same, they believe. Understand? From the same kinship bond, they are related to the same family. Their ancestors are same. Understand? Afterward, in the western Himalaya lived Seferd tribe of Gaddis. The distant northwestern part of the subcontinent too was entirely dominated by tribes of the Nagas, Ahoms and many others. Understand? We get that in Himalaya region, Gaddis tribe and afterward Nagas and Ahoms were dominating in the eastern part of the subcontinent. In many areas of present day Bihar and Jharkhand, in present day, Chero chiefdoms had emerged by 12th century. Understand? Chero tribe. Raja Man Singh, Akbar's famous general, attacked and defeated the Cheros in 1591. A large amount of booty means that he looted large amount of precious things was taken by them. But they were not entirely subdued. Who were not subdued? Chero. Chero tribe had not been subdued by Akbar's famous general मानसिंह. अंडर औरंगजेब मुगल फोर्सेस कैप्चर्ड मेनी चेरो फोर्ट्रेसेस एंड डिफीटेड द ट्राइब. अंडरस्टैंड. इन औरंगजेब रेन द मुंडाज एंड सेंटल्स वर अमंग द अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्राइब दैट लिव इन दिस रीजन एंड ऑल्सो इन उड़ीसा एंड बंगाल. द मुंडाज एंड सेंटल्स इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्राइब देवर लिविंग इन उड़ीसा एंड बंगाल. द महाराष्ट्र हाईलैंड्स एंड कर्नाटका वर होम ऑफ कोलीज बिराज एंड न्यूमरस अदर्स. कोलीज ऑल्सो लिव्ड इन मैनी एरियाज ऑफ गुजरात. फर्दर साउथ देयर वर लार्ज ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन ऑफ कोरागाज बेतास मारवार्स एंड मैनी अदर्स. अंडरस्टैंड. इन गुजरात एरिया एंड आफ्टरवर्ड इन साउथ एरिया लार्ज ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन वर फाउंड कोरागाज बेतास मारवार्स एंड मैनी अदर्स. द लार्ज ट्राइब ऑफ भील्स वॉज स्प्रेड अक्रॉस वेस्टर्न एंड सेंट्रल इंडिया. By the late 16th century, many of them had become settled agriculturalists and some even zamindars. Understand? In 16th, late 16th century, Bhil, the tribal group, became zamindar and they became agriculturalists. Understand? They started to farm the land. Many Bhil clans nevertheless remained hunter-gatherers. They were not hunter-gatherers, Bhils. The Gonds were found in great numbers across the present states of Chhattisgarh. We can get Gonds tribe. Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh. We can get Gond tribes in Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Andhra Pradesh. Understand? Afterward, we will come on the next subtopic. The subtopic is how nomads and mobile people lived. Nomads, the people who go one place to another place. Mobile people lived. Mobile people, the people who are going one place to another place. Understand? They are not staying at one place for a long time. That people are known as what? Mobile people. How nomads and mobile people lived. Nomadic pastoralists. Pastoralists means one who goes in search of pasture meadows for their cattle. Understand? Nomadic pastoralists moved over long distances with their animals. They lived on milk and another pastoral products. Understand? They also exchanged wool, ghee, etc. with settled agriculturalists for grains, cloth, utensils and other products. The pastoralists who were going one place to another place, they were exchanging their things, pastoral products. And that products were wool, ghee, they were exchanging. And in exchange, they got from agriculturalists, from the farmers, what they got? Grains, cloth and utensils. Understand? And other products they also got. They bought, the pastoralist, one who goes one place to another place. They bought and sold these goods as they moved from one place to another place, transporting them on their animals. They were transporting ghee, wools, and they were also exchanging the things from settled agriculturalists, and they got grains, utensils and other products from the farmers, agriculturalists. Understand? The Banjaras were the most important trader nomads. The Banjaras, another tribe, they were the most important trader nomads. Nomads means one who goes one place to another place. And their caravan was called Tanda. Caravan group, understand? The Banjaras were the most important trader nomads, and the caravan was called Tanda. Their group was called Tanda. Sultan Alauddin Khalji, in chapter 3rd, we read, used the Banjaras to transport grain to the city markets. Understand? Emperor Jahangir wrote in his memoirs that the Banjaras carried grain on their bullocks from different areas and sold it in towns. They transported food grain for the Mughal army during military campaigns. With a large army, there could be 1 lakh bullocks carrying grain. Understand? So we know that Banjaras were important trader nomads, and they worked for Emperor Jahangir. They also worked for Sultan Alauddin Khalji. They carried grain on their bullocks from different areas and they sold it in towns. Understand? And they also transported food grain for the Mughal army during military campaigns. With a large army, there could be 1 lakh bullocks carrying grain. Peter Mundi, an English trader who came to India during the early 17th century, has described about the Banjaras. Understand? Nomads and itinerant people who were known as nomads and itinerant groups. Nomads are wandering people. Many of them are pastoralists who roam from one pasture to another pasture with their flocks and herds. Understand? So we know that nomads and itinerant groups, nomads are what? Wandering people who go one place to another place in search of pasture land, meadows for their cattle, with their herds, with their flocks. And similarly, itinerant groups such as craftspersons, peddlers and entertainers travel from place to place practicing their different occupation. Both nomads and itinerant groups often visit the same places every year. They visit on the same place every year. Itinerant people and nomads. Understand? Many pastoral tribes reared and sold animals such as cattle and horses to the prosperous people. Different castes of petty peddlers, one who goes one place to another place, also traveled. Petty peddlers, they traveled from one place to another place, from village to village, and they made and sold wares, things such as ropes, reeds, straw matting, you have seen straw mat, and coarse sacks. Sometimes mendicants, one who begs, acted as wandering merchants. They were acting as merchants on that time. Mendicants, one who begs something to other. There were castes of entertainers who performed in different towns and villages for their livelihoods. Understand? So I hope that you have understood all this clearly. Thanks for watching the video.